The San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game is presented by HEB and sponsored by Whataburger, the U.S. Army, University Health System, CPS Energy, Frost, Ancira, Pizza Hut, Thomas J. Henry, Methodist Healthcare, Hallmark University, Taco Cabana, Vulcan Materials Company, Kielbasa Smoked Meats, Lockaway Storage, Baptist Emergency Hospital, Alamo Real Estate Brokers, iDream SA, UIW, the Children's Hospital of San Antonio, and Knight Office Solutions.
Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Alamodome in San Antonio, Texas, for the 41st annual San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. The best, the biggest, the boldest getting one more shot at a high school football game before they go on to conquer the world. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Don Harris, along with my broadcast partner, Mike Hernandez. And Mike, this is one of those great San Antonio traditions that's been going on a long, long time. It's gotten bigger. It's gotten better. It's moved in here to the Alamodome. And you know firsthand, you saw your nephew play in this game years ago.
And that was at the Rock Pile at Alamo Stadium years ago. And from that game, he was actually able to get a scholarship. So for a lot of the kids here, it is a question. They've already been committed to their college or next level, and that's great. But for others, it's an opportunity to have the recruiters and the coaches that are here today, and they're watching to see if they can shine for them and actually get an opportunity to play at that next level.
Some will get a D1 look, some that's D2 it. Or D3. Some, this will be the last football game they ever play, but it's a great tradition. And speaking of some of those high-level recruits, take a look at Jalen Hastings. This guy tore it up for John Jay this year. Of course, he played with Jacob Zeno, who's going to play quarterback at Baylor, and Hastings was an electric back for the Mustangs all season long. He's short in stature, but he is tough. He has a low center of gravity, and he's got that breakaway speed. He is certainly one of the kids that we'll be looking for tonight. And, of course, you got to have guys up front to block for him.
Absolutely, and we've got a few, starting with our next person here that we're going to highlight for. This is Brandon Brown from O'Connor. Now, Don, we got a chance to see him on Thursday Night Lights. This kid is huge, 6'5", 300 pounds. And in the game that I watched, he was just moving people around like they weren't there, just like they were paper. He is a D1, All-State 2017, and All-State this year as well. He was also the 2017 Dave Campbell Texas Football Player Offensive Lineman of the Year. He's got a lot of pedigree, and he is definitely going to be playing at the next level of TCU.
Yeah, his big brothers were all Big 12 performers at Texas Tech, and he will be, of course, playing at TCU. This kid right here, Dante Higgins, was the Express News Player of the Year, the quarterback from Madison who initially committed to Illinois State. He has changed his commit. He is going to go to UIW now. And by far, if you ask the coaches in that Northeast Independent School District, this was the most electric player in their district and maybe the entire city all season long. He can do it all. He can play receiver at the next level. He's a quarterback, and UIW thrilled that he changed his commitment from Illinois State to right here playing in San Antonio for the Cardinals, and they got a good one in this kid right here. Don't be surprised if he has a couple of electric plays here today.
I won't be surprised at all. And a great pickup for UIW. That's going to really help their program. All right, certainly last but not least, this is Monty Clark. He's a linebacker out of Bernie. Again, we saw him play. This kid is just electric on defense. He's a linebacker, 4A All-State Defensive Player of the Year. Okay, look at his numbers, 147 tackles, 88 solo, and he also had 10 sacks, 6'2", 225. You know he's going to the next level.
Kids having a fun time all week competing with the very best. When we come back, we'll meet the coaches. That's right, it's the 41st annual San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. We're getting closer to kickoff when we come back.
Closed captioning for today's game is sponsored by Baptist Emergency Hospital.
San Antonio middle and high school athletes are doing great things for our community. San Antonio Sports and Methodist Healthcare are shining the light on teams that model key values through their actions. More than 40 teams submitted stories this year, including the Stevens High School Boys Basketball Squad, which hosted a clinic for Special Olympians, and Roosevelt's volleyball team, which raised money to defray a classmate's funeral expenses. Rogers Middle School athletes hosted a food drive for families in their community, and traditional rivals Central Catholic and Holy Cross football teams worked together to support the Guadalupe Community Center. Every team demonstrated important beyond-the-game values of selfless service, caring, sportsmanship, and respect. San Antonio Sports and Methodist Healthcare salute high school and middle school coaches who inspire their teams to serve others. It's time to meet the coaches, and there is Sean McAuliffe, the head coach at Judson, and what a job he's done there. Doing a little differently this year. We're not doing the East versus West geographical split. It's the black team against the gold team, and he is coaching Team Black. McAuliffe, of course, doing a great job there at Judson. He's been 20 years in the business, 5 as the head coach at Judson. Took the Rockets to another deep playoff run this year. He's had some fantastic talent there, including DeMarvin Leal, who played in the earlier game today, the All-American Bowl. And nobody's done a better job in 5 years at a program than McAuliffe, who just keeps that winning tradition alive at Judson. He's a fun guy, and we're going to have a lot of fun with him down on the sidelines later today. Maybe he'll run one of our plays, huh, Mike?
I hope so. I hope we get a chance to have some fun with him and with a team goal head coach as well, Mike Norman. He's from Alamo Heights. He's coached for 28 years and actually 22 of them at Alamo Heights and 7 as the head coach. Now, during his tenure, the Mules have reached the playoffs many times, and they've actually captured the 2006 4A Division State Championship while Norman was actually assistant coach under Don Bryant. So Norman, as a head coach, the Mules have made the state playoffs in 2013, and he has a very successful program there. So again, two really stellar head coaches to lead these young men today.
That's exactly right. It's going to be a fun time. The last game in pads as a high schooler for a lot of these San Antonio and New Braunfels, as you see right there, and area kids. When we come back, we'll have our national anthem and we'll kick it off. The San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB coming up after this.
The San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game is presented by HEB and sponsored by Whataburger, the U.S. Army, University Health System, CPS Energy, Frost, Ancira, Pizza Hut, Thomas J. Henry, Methodist Healthcare, Hallmark University, Taco Cabana, Vulcan Materials Company, Kielbasa Smoked Meats, Lockaway Storage, Baptist Emergency Hospital, Alamo Real Estate Brokers, iDream SA, UIW, the Children's Hospital of San Antonio, and Knight Office Solutions.
Getting closer to kickoff for our national anthem, we turn it over to our public address announcer, Milton Hope.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that this time, please rise for the presentation of our colors and the singing of our national anthem. The colors this evening are presented by the Junior Army ROTC Honor Guard of Breckenridge High School. Also, please welcome Staff Sergeant Nikita Fox from Fort Sam Houston's own, the 323rd Army Band, presenting our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. Still there, oh say, does that star spangled
Very nice. It's time to play football. We are just moments away from kickoff here in the Alamodome.
See the flag being taken off right now, and as soon as it hits the sideline there, you'll see the players applaud, and they'll start to move around, and we'll be ready to play some football.
Hard to believe we've been doing this 41 years. You and I haven't, but they've been playing this game 41 years. The legendary George Pastorchick, who coached at St. Gerard's all those years ago, was a big part of it. The team now gets a trophy in his name's honor.
Yeah, and I'll be doing that at the end of the game, along with the Whataburger Impact Player of the Game. So with a roster like this, any one of these players could end up being that and taking that little trophy home for them and all the memories that come with it.
Never know. We've seen some electric performances over the last few years. Kids who've gone on to make big names from themselves at various college programs around the country.
And even a few that have made their way all the way to the pros. Marcus Davenport, one that sticks out here. He played in this game a few years ago and is now in the pros with New Orleans, with the Saints.
We had former Steel player Cox Wesley go on to Texas Tech. He's coming out early after his junior year, tearing up the Big 12 this year. First team all Big 12 performer. Former Steel Knight, now Texas Tech Red Raider, and he's on his way to the NFL draft. He had a great one-handed catch in this game just about 3 or 4 years ago. Justin Stockton was the MVP, also from Steel High School. He was on a different level when special teams came into play. They were kicking off. Obviously, you don't practice special teams a lot in an all-star game for 1 week, and he had a couple of long returns. And interested to see who is going to be the star here today. Graham Torres from Madison will kick it off as part of our opening kickoff. Carson Valverde from Kerrville Tyvee is back deep, along with Kenyon Morgan from Judson. And it is time for our Hallmark University first half kickoff. Martin's number 14. Star safety for Judson. He's going to play receiver in this game. And here's Torres to do the honors.
Now you know they're fired up for this. Here we go.
And it is kicked right to Morgan. And here he comes. He's got some speed. Look out, Morgan. But a great individual effort on the tackle there. I believe that was 13. Christian Aguilar from Stockdale. Good individual play. And so Team Black will have it first. Of course, Sean McAuliffe, very familiar with Tobias Weaver. He's the quarterback from Wagner, right there in his own backyard. He'll get the start at quarterback. And in the backfield with him is Bernard Danke, the running back from Marshall, who's had some really explosive runs this year. Of course, Weaver led Wagner all the way to the state semifinals, hands to Danke, and Danke gets close to the 30-yard line before being brought down by Monty Cluck, Gabe Morris. Mackie Carabin from Alamo Heights also in there on the tackle.
Weaver's got over 2,046 yards and 27 touchdowns on the ground alone, 2017 and 2018. So he is an accomplished runner as well.
Of course, he's not used to that shotgun formation in the spread. They run that veer or option, whatever you want to call it, at Wagner. More of an old Darryl Royal type offense. He keeps it there. Good job by the Gold defense. Take a look at Weaver's numbers on the year. 87 for 159 and 254 carries. Just a deadly running game they had at Wagner. I think they outscored their opponents 66-6 before they got to take on Shadow Creek.
Yeah, every week it was amazing the numbers they put up.
On the run, fires, and That's short hopped, almost intercepted. And that's Carabin again from Alamo Heights, who had great coverage on the play. Oh, went right through his hands. They're pretty excited right now. You know, they might be overthrowing the ball a little bit, underthrowing it. Just going to take them maybe one rotation each before they actually will settle down. And just like at any other level, you get a little bit of the shakes early on. You're a little nervous. This is a big game for them. Nick Falzone to do the punting honors. Nick Proctor from Alamo Heights. And it's a fake. And the black team is not going to get there. Great pursuit by Team Gold. That's Josiah Gutierrez-Smith from Warren. He smelled that out and made the tackle. Boy, it looked like he had that just pegged the entire way. It didn't actually fool anybody. That's going to give the Gold team some great, great field position. Oh, look at that. They're momentum as well. The 30. All right, let's see what the Gold team can do.
All right, they're led by Reed Anderson here, the starter at quarterback from Alamo Heights. Colton Poole from Bernie is the running back here on the first series. We saw him, the Greyhound, a very durable, tough running back on the inside. He gets the first carry, and he is drilled right at the line of scrimmage and getting up his big number 99, Seth Jaquist from Churchill, who was an all-district performer there for the Chargers, and of course, whose big brother played in this game and is now playing on the special teams unit for the Texas Longhorns and played in the Sugar Bowl the other night. Sets up second down and 11 as you see big Seth Jaquist. Back to pass. Anderson has it completed. That Colton Poole there in the flat, gain of about 4. And he's brought down by JT Mulligan from Reagan High School.
Tackle by number 9, JT Mulligan.
You know, Don, you got to wonder, they've only had a week to really get together and work out some plays. So they're going to have a basic offense and a basic defense there. But you know that each one of these coaches has something special planned. One or two trick plays, one or two special things that they can do.
We've seen one of them on the fake punt. Third down and long, going deep as a man. And oh,
yes.
Oh. Incomplete. Great coverage on the play by Kenyon Morgan from Judson. We talked about him being a star cover guy for the Rockets all season long. Jordan Smith from Brendan, the intended receiver. And he had the ball for a long time, but just staying with it, making sure he took it out there at the end with the strip is Morgan. Fantastic play.
That was a great play. It looked like it was 6 for sure. That very, very last second tear away of the ball. Now it's going to set up. Looks like a field goal.
Well, we've got a player down for the Team Black. It's 4th down and 9. Ball spotted right on about the 27 as they attend to the young man. We can't see from here who that is. And we'll take a break while they attend to him and be back in a scoreless game here in the first quarter.
Tell you what, these tacos, man, we meet the end of the season taco mix.
Terrific.
They took tacos into a tasty new junction.
This good steak, my pay on taco, I'm talking about taste buds, taco turn. This El Pascual taco is totally tilted, totally intensified.
So wait, that taste buds take a tea about tacos and time. Look, is it time to talk tacos?
Yeah, totally. Smash. What do I mean?
Taste the tradition with BGN of HEB season taco meats and 6 authentic flavors.
Do you know what optimism can do? Whatever it wants. We've seen it unlock resilience that makes the impossible inevitable. Inspire generosity to put families back on their feet. And give Davis courage to throw rocks at Goliaths. At Frost, we believe optimism. optimism can change lives emotionally, physically, and financially. And with your help, we're going to prove it.
Welcome back, Coach Mike Norman and his Alamo Heights staff. Has a fourth down and eight. And it looks like they are going to go for it here instead of try the 45-yarder or so. All right, let's see what Coach Norman has up his sleeve here. He's got his own quarterback from Alamo Heights, Reed Anderson.
U.S. Army soldiers don't just dream about life without purpose. They
Proctor to the right side. Fires deep over the middle, double covered, and good coverage there by the black team. And that's Brandon Richard from San Antonio Christian with great coverage. Really the equivalent of about a 3A school playing with the big boys. And Brandon Richard made play after play this season for the Lions in private school ball. He can show now here. He can play with anybody.
Yeah, so far the defense, the defensive backs have been playing very well. A couple of really big plays by them. Turn the ball over now, and it's going to be first down for Team Black on the 27-yard line.
See what personnel changes they have. It's going to be Weaver still in at quarterback. Brandon Adams from Sam Houston's the tailback, and boy, this kid in space is special. Let's see if they get the ball to him. Instead, they fire it out here, incomplete in the flat. That was intended for Connor Beavers from Bernie Champion. We saw him have a big game the night that they played on TNL. See some of the numbers for Brandon Adams from Sam Houston. 2,000 yards through his career, and almost 1,000 yards receiving. He's small at 5'8", 160, but I guarantee you, if he's not the fastest kid on the field, he's one of the top three. He's just blazing speed when that kid gets in space.
Absolutely, he's got another gear. You could see it clearly when he gets the ball.
And a jet sweep here. Doing a good job staying with the coverage and staying home is number two, Brent Malone from Brandeis. And he's not going to get faked out. Brent Malone is a smart kid. You know where he's going to play his college football?
Where?
Harvard.
Yes.
So you know he's smart staying at home. He knows the scheme.
6'2", 215. He's got the size for it, too. Either way he goes.
Some good options. Tells me he's going to do all right in life.
I think so.
Third down now. Weaver in the shotgun. Gonna roll it to his right. Got three receivers over there. He's got a man wide open for the first down. It's caught. And getting out of bounds is Connor Beavers, the young man from Bernie Champion. So a nice job of moving his sticks by Team Black and Tobias Weaver. Out of his element a little bit running this offensive system, but does a good job on that play of completing it and moving the sticks. A Kielbasa smoked meat first down.
Yeah, their pass run option worked very well for them, and I expect them to come back to that probably off and on throughout that game because they had all three of them were open.
That's a Pizza Hut first down, Mike.
I thought so.
Yeah. Well, you're eating both. First and 10 on 40. Hand inside to Adams. Nowhere to go. Interior lineman doing a good job for Team Gold there. And big number 45, Jamie Ferguson from Madison.
So far, the black team has not had any success running the ball inside. Matter of fact, neither team has. So even with those big offensive linemen, the defense is holding tight, at least at this point.
Three receivers here to the left for Weaver on second down. Gets out of trouble. He's got room to run. And Tobias Weaver, he's showing his speed to the 40, cuts back and gets out of bounds. Inside Gold territory, and there you see Tobias Weaver and what he did all season long for the Wagner T-Birds, who were by far the team of the year in San Antonio. 24-yard pickup for Weaver.
Look at that. Look at him turn that corner. Look at the speed. Changes the ball hand to protect it. I thought he was going to go out of bounds there about 10 yards before, but he managed to stay in. Another 10 yards added to that. Just a great run.
I tell you this, he didn't get there, but scouts will be impressed with Jaquiss's speed to the corner that almost got him. That was incredible. There's a little pass out into the flat. Nice cutback move.
And the ball's out. Gold says they have it, but they don't. Anaya Spencer from Judson on the reception. Lose the ball to the 29-yard line. It'll be second down at about six. Anaya Spencer, one of those Rockets that had a big season. 18 catches, 130 yards. They had athletes all over the field there at Converse Judson this year. Second down and five. Weaver, blitz, and gets out of it. Can run if he wants. Flags down, completes the pass. And another flag is down for a late face mask. So we may have offsetting with a hold and a late face mask as the ball was complete to Hayden Haas from Seguin. So we'll let him sort it all out and see the penalties.
So far, been very impressed with Tobias Weaver. He's thrown two very, very good passes down the field. I know he's more of a running kind of quarterback, but he has really, really shown.
Two fouls on the play. Holding, number 60, Black. Personal foul, face mask, number 20, Gold. Those penalties offset, replay, second down.
All right, so they'll replay the down. David Eagleton leading our officiating crew. And
look at this throw, Don. On the run, right on the money, with some speed.
And a good catch by Haas to bring it in. So we'll redo it at second down and five. Three receivers to the right for Weaver. See if he rolls that way. Steady hands inside, and going nowhere is Jalen Hastings, the young back from John Jay. And on the tackle is Gabriel Morris from Southside.
Jalen Hastings is another one of those individuals that you just got to give him a little bit of room, and he is going to explode, and it's going to be see you later. Over 4,500 yards and 36 touchdowns from 2016 to 18. This is one special ball player.
All right, third down and four. Blitz coming, little dump off, and it's picked off. Intercepted by Team Gold. Big number 93, Broderick Howard from Steele, had great coverage in the flat and just took it away from the smaller Hastings.
Looks like he wasn't fooled. He stays with the block, and managed to tip it. That's why they practice those tip drills, Don.
What a specimen Broderick Howard is. 6'4", 250 pounds. And he gets the turnover cape. The king, the T.O. king. He gets to wear the cape for a series.
There you go. That's great.
All right, Dante Hagen's in at quarterback for Team Gold now from Madison. Told you how electric he is keeping it. Hagen's off to the races. Watch out, Dante Hagen's may be gone. Got one man to beat to the corner. And he's knocked out of bounds inside the 15 at about the 11-yard line. Dante Hagen saying, hey guys, I'm here. Mario Gomez from Central Catholic had the angle, but we told you in the pregame about the speed and the electricity of this young man, and he wastes no time making an impact. 53 yards on the game. Inside the Night Office Solutions red zone. He's got Yamani Crawford from Cole behind him. Hands to him, spins out of one tackle, lunges for the five, and gets down to about the 7-yard line. So fresh legs in there at the skill positions for Team Gold after that turnover.
I understand that Higgins actually was playing basketball, had a basketball game before he came down here to this one, so he was already warmed up.
Yeah, played in the Mavericks game this afternoon. Now on second down, he hands to Crawford again, and Crawford's going nowhere as the Team Black defense did a nice job making the play there. In on the tackle, Cody Boatman, Gabriel Diaz from O'Connor, and also
Darren Taylor from Seguin there. Third down and eight after that huge play for Higgins. They might be smart here to keep it in his hands. He can buy time like anybody you've ever seen down here, give him a chance to roll out. Look for some sort of an RPO done. Snap it to him.
No, he's got a straight drop.
A pump, buys himself some time, directing traffic. Now will take it himself and spins, flips down to the 2 yard line. It'll be fourth and goal as Hilario Gomez from Central Catholic made the tackle. And they'll go for it here, I would think, on fourth and one. And if.
Are you a betting man, Don?
I'm a betting man, quarterback, shotgun. Quarterback run all the way.
I think so.
No. Inside to Crawford. Touchdown, team goal. Yamani Crawford, the 6 foot, 180 pound back from the home of Shaquille O'Neal, puts team goal on the board first at 6-0.
So it looks like the defense was thinking the same thing we were, that Higgins was going to keep the ball.
Good blocking up front. Pretty easy trip into the end zone. On to kick the extra point, Graham Torres from Madison. And it is up and it is good. Gold strikes first, 7-0 here at the Alamo Dome. Back with much more after this. We are back. There's Yamani Crawford from Cole. First one to get in. As you can see, our cheer cam all year long. We ask you to vote for your favorite squad in the San Antonio All-Star Cheer Challenge, powered by CPS Energy. And you're looking at the Canyon Lake squad there. Just one of the winning teams on our CPS Energy cheer cam. Congratulations. I know it's a big thrill for them to be here doing this. As Hilario Gomez from Central Catholic and Anaya Spencer from Judson, deep to return this one off the foot of Elian Valdez. That's taken by Gomez and tries to get outside. Got a team of blockers there. Takes on tacklers and a really good return across the 35-yard line.
So good field position. Let's see if there's a change on Team Black as far as some of their personnel.
Monty Cluck on the tackle there, as we'll take a look at the Team Black offense. Tobias Weaver being replaced by Carson Valverde from Kerrville Tyvee. He was the unanimous District 27 5A most valuable player. 14 touchdowns, 1,800 yards. And he's the man at the helm right now for Team Black. Runs a little option. Breaking the first tackle and now breaking loose and trying to get down the sidelines is Bernard Dankey from Marshall, and sees some of the talent that he had, you heard about all year if you didn't see him play. Does a great job getting off the first tackle, and he's got size and speed.
He does, squares those shoulders around very well, and got a very low center of gravity. You can pick that up very, very quickly, and that helped him break those tackles.
That'll set up second down and four. Call it three. Ball's out. Valverde gets it back. Now fires and overshoots his intended receiver. He was looking for Kenneth Bivens Jr. from Clark. And good pressure there by Team Gold made him throw it higher than he wanted to. And he overthrew his intended receiver. Bivens, if he gets his hands on the ball, he too is a very, very fast player who can turn it into 6 points really quickly.
Setting up a third and four now. Let's see what Team Gold has in mind.
You see the Whataburger player profile on Carson Valverde. He likes the patty melt. Likes a sweet tea. See if he can like a first down. There's Bivens, watch out. Bivens didn't have the speed to get past the defender there. As Darius Dillard from Sam Houston, Connor Beavers. Excuse me, it was Beavers on the reception.
Very close to the first
Down marker. It looks like they're giving it to him.
That pass and catch good for a first down.
And they're moving the sticks. First down for Team Black. Nearing midfield. Oop. Big left tackle jumped.
False start, 76 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Hard to miss, big Wyatt Tate, 6'6", 310 pounds.
5-yard penalty moves it back to the 40-yard line.
He's on his way to Stephen F. Austin. You would think he would do well with that size. And certainly, Lumberjacks have discovered him. Valvery hands it.
Oh, yeah! Lucky.
Danky forward for about four before he's brought down.
Danky on the carry.
That'll set up second down and 11.
Looks like that Team Black's offensive line is starting to get a little bit of momentum. Just watching Brandon Brown, their number 76. He's actually been moved to tackle, which his normal position is guard. But they're starting to actually get a little bit of movement off that line.
Yes, sir. Second down and 11. Straight drop. Valverde wants to throw it up top. Got a man. Caught and inbounds. A nice catch by number 14, Kenyon Morgan, who's doing it all today.
That was a great catch.
26 yards.
Right to his back shoulder. Look at that. How did he come down with that ball?
That's a matchup that he's seen before. One-on-one with Xavier Player out of Steele. They're rivals.
And still have the presence of mind to come down with at least 1 foot inbound.
Big momentum swing there. First down for Team Black. Carson Valverde in there at quarterback. That time he just airmails it, intended for Morgan, who comes up limping a little bit. And checking in is Randolph's Devin Odom, big 6'6", 211-pound tight end. On second down and 10. Black team spotted the gold 7, trying to get back in it and tie it up here. Beavers and Bivens split to the right. Valverde keeps, and a nice quarterback run there by Tyvee Antler, following in the footsteps of one that we've saw years ago, Johnny Manziel, and Zaya Williams on the tackle. Play a good brand of football out there in Kerrville.
Yes, they do. Nice fake. Turned the ball inside. Nice hole opened up by the offensive line there. For a good game.
Minute 25 to go here in the first quarter as Carson Valverde from Kerrville Tyvee has a 3rd and 5 as Team Black tries to get on the board for the first time. He keeps again. Bounces this one outside. And he is drilled. Oh, what a hit. Ethan Still from Smithson Valley. If that wasn't him, it was Jacob Demarius from Johnson. And that was just a big time hit. Josiah Gutierrez Smith from Warren, third time's a charm. And we're going to look at a 42-yard attempt. And this is big number 72 doing the kicking. Oswaldo Luna from Hondo, Texas. The Owl. Does he have enough? He does. 42-yarder from the big fella. And the Black team is on the board. 7-3 gold with 15 seconds to go here in the first quarter.
I am Warren Hunter, and I would
Welcome back to the Alamo Dome. It's the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. Into the first quarter here, just 15 ticks left as the gold team has a 7-3 lead after that 42-yard field goal by Luna, Oswaldo Luna of Hondo.
Looks like he had a few yards to spare there, Don.
Yeah,
probably could have gone another four or five yards.
Ethan Sill and Yamani Crawford back to receive the kick. High kick taken about the 7 by Crawford. He's got a touchdown here today. He spins out of trouble and does a nice job getting past the 25, down to about the 27-yard line before being brought down by JT Mulligan of Reagan. White team getting ready to send their offense out. Of course, they had a lot of success on the last drive with Dante Higgins from Madison at quarterback. After Reed Anderson got the start.
Nice drive by Team Black, though, even though they had to come up with a settle for the field goal, that they did hold the ball for a few minutes, and they put together a nice drive. Of course, with Hagan, it was pretty much that one play that set up that entire scoring for a team goal.
Taylor Mills in at quarterback from Marion, Texas. Quarterback draw on his first call. He gets to the outside. He does a good job diving close to the stick. Got at least 9. Carlos Reyes from Central Catholic on the tackle, and that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter. It's the Black 7, the Gold 3, with the Gold squad trying to add to that. Actually, it's the Gold 7, Black 3, Gold with the football when we come back into the second quarter. Welcome back to the Alamo Dome. It's the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. Gold on top of Black, 7-3, as you're looking at Taylor Mills, quarterback from Marion, Texas. All-Stater in Class 3A on the second team. Threw 55 touchdowns in his career, only 14 interceptions. He got a little reverse and trying to snuff it out and snuffing it out, making a great play is Seth Jaquess from Churchill. Oh my goodness. Seth looks like he's put some weight on and he can run. 99 not having any of this. Showing speed for the big fella. Seth's committed to UIW. Big get for that program. Eric Morris, coach of the year. Straight drop from Mills, has all day. Still waiting. Now he's going to take off and he's going to be hit, met, caught, and dropped. Making the tackle there is Cody Boatman from Clemens. And that'll bring up fourth down and punting situation for the Gold. Black team will have good field position right at about the 40-yard line. Nice punt, fair catch, called for and taken right at midfield, and that's where the Black team will have it. When we come back, they're trailing 7-3 here at the Alamo Dome. Welcome back to the Alamo Dome. Vulcan Materials Company first down for Team Black. Carson Valverde, still the quarterback. Brandon Adams from Sam Houston in a tailback on this series. And it's a reverse. And going to try and throw it, and throwing it, and caught! Team Black, all the way down to the 5-yard line. That's Hayden Haas. And what a throw.
Kenneth Bivens from Clark is the kid who aired it out. Adams to Bivens to Haas. And Bivens didn't hesitate, even though it was double coverage. 44 yards. Team Black inside the night red zone, knocking on the door at the 7. Valverde to Adams. Straight ahead, maybe the line of scrimmage. Good defensive push there.
Brendan Adams from San Houston on the carry.
Gold squad's defensive front having none of that one. Good interior push. Nathan Cano from Taft in there. Big Kalen Williams from Warren is a star as well. Dominated the football game that we had earlier this year on TNL, did Williams. Here's a jet sweep, trying to get to the corner. Spencer, kid from Judson, dives for the pylon. Touchdown, Team Black. Anaya Spencer, great effort to dive for the cone at the end of that run as the defensive pursuers got to him, but he just lunged in there. Oswaldo Luna, who has a 42-yarder to his credit today. Ended the ads, add the extra point, and hopefully make it 10-7 for the Black. We missed that one. So that's where we stand, 9-7 Black Squad. We're coming back with more here in the second quarter. Back in the Alamodome, where the Black team has gone ahead. Anaya Spencer from Judson. Look at the second effort to dive for the cone. Gets there and gives Team Black the 2-point lead. Extra point no good, and they'll do kickoff honors. Nice crowd on hand here at the Alamodome. Everybody having a good time after that All-American Bowl where we had a couple of local kids. Jordan Whittington from Cuero. And of course, DeMarvin Leal from Judson playing in the national game. Ethan Sill from Smithson Valley back to receive the kick. All right. And here we go. Low line driver. It'll be Sill trying to get wide, showing some speed. Nice across the 30 to the 35-yard line, and let's go down to the sidelines and Mike Hernandez. Mike?
All right, I'm joined by a very special gentleman, a gentleman we know from Thursday Night Lights as well. This is Lieutenant Colonel D'Angelo Blunt. How are you, sir?
Hey, sir, I'm outstanding. I'm pleased to be here again. Thank you.
Well, listen, first off, really appreciate the Army still being a part of this. This is so important to us and I think to the community. And there's a lot of things that kind of relate between the Army and team sports, isn't that right?
Absolutely, sir. We all share the same common values. You know, we use the acronym leadership, loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. And what better way to talk about a team effort than with football in Texas? So you can't beat it.
Are you enjoying the game so far?
Yes, sir, I'm loving every bit of it. I'm excited. These kids out here are doing great things, and they got an exciting future for themselves, sir.
They do. They really do. And it's the gold and black?
Hey, sir, the gold and black. So the Army has an opportunity to represent on both sides, gold and black. And as you know, hey, anytime you got the Army involved, you got an exciting experience ahead of you.
So why did you all get involved in this in the first place?
So, sir, what better way, though, to show how we're about the community, right? So a lot of people just seem to forget that. And when we're here and showing all the things that we can do to help the community out as a whole, you know, it's important that we showcase that. And then not just that, to provide kids options. You know, if they hadn't thought about serving, we would encourage them that they do that. You know, a chance to serve your country is something that I've been blessed with, and it's provided a better life for not just me, my family, but this country as a whole. So we can give these kids options when they finish school, i.e. college tuition, $40,000 possible, or TA tuition, $40,000 a year.
That's an outstanding opportunity for him, sir.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you about next. You all are involved in so many other things than just this. But this is important because I think it gives you all an ability to be seen as a part of the community and as a viable option to some of these young 17, 18, 19-year-old men and women who are interested in pursuing a career in the Army.
Absolutely, sir. So if you haven't thought about it, I would encourage anyone to take the time and go talk to a recruiter or talk to a veteran and ask them what their experience was like, because you just don't know it, and it's important that you're informed before you make any decision in life.
Colonel Blunt, it's always a pleasure.
Hey, sir, it absolutely
is. Thank you for your service. Hey,
thank you for having me, sir.
All right. All right, Don, this is a very special gentleman right here. Hey, and by the way, I'm actually going to be staying down here now, and I'm going to try to interview some of the players and spend some time down here. So hate to leave you out in the booth, but I know you could do well without me. You'll be just fine.
No, I need you. I need you. Turn around, get them headsets on, get to work.
All right. Listen. I'm here if you need me.
Mike Hernandez also served. Thank those gentlemen for their service. And certainly want to thank the Army for their involvement here in the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game. Yamani Crawford in, and this is Johnny Zamora from Pleasanton at quarterback. Little jet sweep coming this way and going nowhere. Good pursuit from behind on that entire play. And I believe that was Clifford Geyer from Clark coming from the backside. And Clifford stayed with this play and ran it down. Kenyon Morgan back to receive the punt, as it's fourth down and 11 for Team Gold.
Valdez punching for Team Gold.
Good pressure right up the middle. Morgan's going to have some room right up the middle, getting to the outside. And he ducks and dodges right out there at midfield. And 19-yard return by the young man from Judson, who's really shown out today, both offensively and defensively.
Yeah, let's go, go.
Playing both ways. You see the CPS cheer cam with the New Braunfels unicorn cheerleaders. Which brings up a question. Unicorn? Unicorn. Isn't it unicorn? Think about it. When you see that animal, it's a unicorn. He has one horn. I don't know, just an observation. First down and 10 for Team Black. Running this way is Derek Perez, the quarterback from Churchill, who had a great year for the Chargers. A utility player. He can do it all, a little running back, a little receiver, a little slot receiver, quarterback. Threw for 26 touchdowns in his career, over 2,000 yards, and ran for almost 2,000, and another 15. 6'1", 180. Sets up second down and 10. Three receivers to his left. Perez has the guy one-on-one down the sideline. He just overthrew big, tall number 89, Devin Oden from Randolph. Good coverage by Micah Garcia from Jefferson in there now. As we reach the 5:27 mark here, the second quarter. Of course, Perez has played a lot of different schemes at Churchill, played in the shotgun, run the spread a little bit there as a sophomore. And the Chargers changed their offense to more of a single wing. Yeah.
Hey, Don, I've got Coach Sean McAuliffe here. How are you doing, Coach?
Good. Hopefully we get a first down here.
What's the call?
What'd you call?
I can tell you it's either going to be a run, and it appears to be a pass at this moment. and he's running for his life. And he's still running. And we're fixing to punt the football.
So you enjoyed? Did you enjoy this week with the guys?
You know what? It's a fun deal. You get to meet some new kids, and I'll be honest with you, quite a few of these kids we played against, and I thought the way that they divided this deal up was kind of interesting. So you know, like the Brandon Brown kid from O'Connor that we played in some pretty good playoff games, and then the kids in our own district. I say that Tobias Weaver, those guys were with us up in the 6A for a while, the kid from Wagner, and then, you know, it's been a fun deal.
Good. Well, it looks like the team has got – how many plays did you guys put in? Because it looks like you've got quite a selection there.
Well, it looks kind of fancy on there, but there's a lot of repeats on that little cord that kid's got in his waist. No, I'll tell you what, here's the deal. These kids all come from really good programs, and they're all really well coached, and – you know, that makes the job of coaching an All-Star game pretty easy.
Well, I'll let you get back to it, and I'm going to come by there in a few minutes. We're going to help you call some plays.
Heck yeah, we can do it.
All right. Thank you, Coach. All right, Don, I'll send it back to you. That's you heard the invitation. We're good to go. So think of some plays that we might be able to.
You need to get his offensive coordinator, though, because Sean doesn't know what's going on. He's delegated that.
Yes, I know.
All right, the gold team coming back on. Sean McAuliffe, one of the great guys and coaches in San Antonio, as is Mike Norman, always having a good time going out there and talking to those guys at their respective schools and fantastic jobs that they have done. As Johnny Zamora in at QB again from Pleasanton on a Vulcan Materials Company first down. And we should see a yellow hanky. There it is. He was looking for his big tight end, Oscar Cardenas from Brandeis, who's signed with UTSA, probably one of the top recruits in this game, along with Brandon Brown, who's going to TCU. Kevon Brown from Wagner.
Pass interference, number 20, defense. 15-yard penalty for the previous spot, automatic first down.
Kind of got his feet tangled up with him.
15-yard penalty.
Just kind of tripped him as his leg went out from under him. Kevon Barnes, a really talented safety there at Wagner. And here's Johnny Zamora's numbers over the 3 years at Pleasanton. Over 7,000 yards and 72 touchdowns. Wow. That's incomplete. Just a little high for the intended receiver on the sideline, and that'll set up third down and 10. As we get ready for the halftime showdown, they're stretching. First, second graders. Today, flag. Tomorrow, they'll be right here. It goes by so quick. Dante Hagans back in at quarterback for the gold. And we saw what he did on his one and only series, quickly let him down the field. And they hand it to him, and there he is, making it look easy. By far one of the most talented skill position people out here today. A lot of great players here, but none better than number six.
I've got a bunch down here, Don, that might argue that with you. And I wouldn't argue with them.
Brandon Adams, maybe.
I've got the entire offensive line here for Team Black. Introduce yourself, guys.
I'm Antonio Gonzalez.
What school?
Floresville.
Wyatt Tate, Navarro High School.
Brandon Brown, O'Connor.
Carson Ferris, Reagan.
I missed one.
Corey Dabbs, Bernie Champion.
Andrew Pruski, Churchill.
Michael Valadez, Stevens.
Jeremy Rodriguez, Harlando.
Okay, so do y'all, what do they feed you guys? I mean, because, geez, Louise. You know, anything you want, yeah. My mama used to tell me if you don't want to feel short, hang around with smaller people if you, you know, that kind of thing. So, what do you think of the game so far?
Yeah, it's just been a fun atmosphere. You know, just come out here and play with guys we don't know yet. You know, meeting them all this week, playing against guys, you know, might have played with when you were younger. Just really just coming out here and having fun with each other.
Yeah, has it been a challenge for you guys playing against other athletes that are at y'all's level, you know, practicing day in, day out, and then out here in the game?
Yeah, it's been a challenge, especially for me coming from a smaller school, but I feel like for everyone it has been playing against such good competition and seeing what we're really worth out here.
Well, guys, keep it up. Good luck.
Hey, Mike, I got one question.
You got one question, all right?
How many gallons a week per man per week do they go through?
Gallons of
milk.
Milk? Oh, we got some big milk drinkers here?
Oh,
How many gallons?
How many gallons of milk?
A week.
They go to three, probably four, yeah, four a day.
Four? A day?
A day? You got milk? You got milk? Yeah.
Back to you, Dad.
A day. I don't know if I believe that, but I believe between the group of them, there's probably a probably 50 gallons a week between that group right there. That'll eat you out of house and home. That's why the parents are so glad to see him go off to college. Somebody else is paying for it. All right, so the goal team is going to have to turn it over on downs. Fourth down and 15 after a good defensive possession by the Black. And they're faking it. They're throwing it. And they completed it. Down to the 20. They didn't even show punt. Black team didn't know what was going on. And it's Higgins as the receiver sneaking down the sidelines. Maki Carabin from Alamo Heights. He kind of snuck off the field like he was leaving and then just ran a straight route down the sideline and was wide open. Nice throw by Carabin. New set of downs. We'll check the quarterback for the gold. That's Zamora. Fires into the flat. Caught, breaking a tackle. And spinning inside the 20 is Raul Augusto from South Sand. A lot of different schools represented here today, over 60. Brandon Richard making the tackle. You see Augusto, he played some quarterback as well. And right up the middle, breaking tackles and getting down to the two is Colton Poole from Bernie. We know how good he is. Good tough runner from the Greyhounds. They're gonna mark him down at about the three. As we go inside the Knight Office Solutions red zone. Another inside handoff and pulling forward. Touchdown, gold. Colton Poole, the Bernie Greyhound. Pushes the gold team back in front. Good football game here at the Dome. Good job by the offensive line up front. Surge. As Graham Torres comes on for the extra point. Try to make it 14-9. It's a low line drive, but it's good. And we'll keep it here as the gold team goes back in front. Time for our Alamo Real Estate Brokers Smile Cam. The gold team with a lot to smile about. And that little young lady does too. How cute is that? Smile Cam brought to you by Alamo Real Estate Brokers, leading you home. She's having a good time here, as are the fans. Good football game, 13-9 our score. As we near the end of the first half, 1:31 to play, and the Black team will have one more shot at trying to punch it in. Colton Poole's got his name in the paper. Good tough run right up the middle, and the gold doing a nice job of converting a fake punt on fourth down with that route right down the sideline to Dante Higgins. Graham Torres to do the honors, kicking it off. And it's Kenyon Morgan from Judson again, who's had a lot of touches today. He gets to the outside. No flag on that one block. He's still fighting through a scrum at the 34. And a really good crackback block sprung him at about the 10-yard line. Kenyon Morgan continues to have a big day here in the All-Star game. They got a minute 20 to go. So they'll run a little two-minute drill here, will Team Black. this might be a good time to go to Mike Hernandez and the team black offensive coordinator, see what he's got called up here with just a two-minute drill here. All three timeouts left.
Where's my offensive coordinator? Mr. Williams.
Hi. Adrian Ronhell in.
You're live.
Well, I'm live.
So what did you call for?
Well, we're going to try to get our receiver across the middle right here, hoping they don't blitz. Number two is going to clear it out. We're going to swing the back this way. And there goes. That's the middle. He's open. It didn't work.
Look good on paper, though.
Yeah, it looked good on paper. Call it, Joe. Call it, Joe. So, Adrian, minute and 13 seconds. I got one trick play in my sleeve, but I want to get it a little further down.
No foul on the play. Number 11 is in the
see
area.
See if we can see him right here. Let me see what we got here. I'm letting my other coaches call a little few plays, too, so let them have some fun.
What's it like having all that beef on that line? And look at that. There's got every one of them's got to be 250 plus.
Yeah, they're some good boys. Look, they had a good Thanksgiving, too, so. We're going to run the ball, see what they can do right here. We're going to run it right now with the big boys, see what we got. Oh, that's a good push. There we go. That's a play.
Dude, that was the first down.
Big boys. But no, this is fun. I mean, we're trying to, in a week, it's kind of hard to do what you want to do. But we're trying to teach them the smash mouth way we do at Judson and throw the ball to the athletes every now and then. Just basically trying to let the kids have some fun.
So what's the next play?
I missed it. The third one, probably going to run the same play. Oh, we're going to run sprint. There you go. Sprint, we call that sprint hook. Got the curl with the wheel route. See if we can get another.
Is it time for that trick play yet?
Not yet. We just call a timeout. We're going to try to get a field goal in here. Try to get some momentum going to the halftime, hopefully. But we'll see. I think our guy's good for about 45 right now.
Okay. All right. What's the call? What's the call here? Looks like they're going to do something in a hurry here.
That is. There you go. A little sprint out, a little roll out, trying to move the chain. Gonna get closer right here. 28 seconds. We got a timeout, two left.
Ball on the, was it 44?
The 44.
36 now.
I don't know. They looking.
How close do they have to get for the field goal for you?
I think he's good from 40. I think he's good from 40. So if we can get about 10 more yards at least we're gonna have a shot at it. See what happens here.
You know what they call here?
Getting a 3-by-1 set. I don't know if we got Bivens. Oh, we're gonna go double pass right here. Here we go.
Oh, double pass. Keep your eye on number six.
Oh,
now
didn't
he's
do it.
Forward. Little screen.
That didn't work.
They were all over that.
Burn the timeout.
They got us on the screen. So now we got, what, 22 seconds? I might go put the trick play in right here.
Okay. All right, he says he's
go with him, Mike. Let's see how fast you can run, Mike.
He says he thinks he's going to do that trick play here. He's going in there to tell him.
Got third and five.
Third and five, 36-yard line. Says they probably need another 20 yards here for the field goal. Said he was good from about 40. Now you can see they're huddling up there, talking about it.
They're thinking field goal right now, but they have two more timeouts and 22 seconds. Plenty of time, but they got third and five, so they need to convert. I think he may go back to that double pass with Kenneth Bivens from Clark is what he was talking about.
Yeah, he thought that was called the play before, as you said there. So let's see what they do. I think that's part of their trick play. But I'll ask him here as soon as he comes off.
Gold team leads it, 14-9. Black team trying to get a little momentum. All right, let's get it, Mike, before they run it.
Before they run it, what'd you end up calling?
All right, now we're getting ready to do a little trick play right here. So we're gonna hope it happens. And good, now he's gonna come back.
There it is, double pass. Nothing doing.
Coach.
Brent Malone, the kid going to Harvard, making the tackle. With 14 seconds to go and another timeout.
I forgot to throw the ball. So 14 seconds left now, Don.
Defense, get ready.
You got another play?
Oh, yeah.
Fourth and 10.
Yeah, whether or not it's any good, I don't know. But we're going to dial something up here. We'll see.
Yeah, just so you know, the kid that made the tackle, he's going to Harvard, so he sniffed that one out.
Well, it helps having, you know, it helps having a brain and the athleticism, and I'd imagine if you're going to Harvard, you're a pretty talented individual.
That's right. All right, let me see if Coach has something. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
There he is. Let's hear it before you go.
All right, Coach.
The quick play didn't work, so we're going to try another one here. We're going to send the running back right up the middle of the field. It's wide open right now. Keeping out running linebacker.
Oh, Jalen Hastings out of the backfield. Is going to run straight up the middle with nobody there. You can see there's no safety there. He's got to roll over to the second. Anybody going to pick him up? A linebacker picked him up, but good pursuit up front. The goal team snuffing it out with great defense. Patrick Rhodes from Cole, they brought a blitz and there was no time.
Dan, you got to remember, there are one, two, three, there are four linebackers on team goal that are all staters.
Yeah.
Four.
A minus 24-yard play. And so now, with 8 seconds to go, you might could run an out route and then get big 72 out there to see if he can kick another field goal. He's good from 42 today. You could throw real quick over the middle, call timeout, and run him out there. You got the whole field if you're the gold team with three timeouts. Got to do something quick, maybe a quick slant, pick up about 8 to 10, and then call timeout as soon as you hit the ground.
All right, let's see what they do here.
We still see you. It doesn't matter.
Looks like the defense is set up in a prevent. So they're giving them some room over the middle.
They got the whole field to work with. They only have 8 seconds, though. They got to do something quick. There's a good quick route. Get out of bounds. And he does. Now they can try that field goal with 3 seconds left. Big 72 is good from, that was on the black squad, so we're going to see what kind of leg the gold kicker has.
3 seconds left.
This is why they're all-stars. And this is Graham Torres from Madison. His career long is 48. This will be 39. So very manageable for a high school kicker at 39. Last snap of the first half as the goal looks to add to their lead. Good snap, low kick, and he pulled it left, and it's no good. Just didn't hit it. Needed a few more on the driving range. It's halftime, and the gold team still has the lead, even though they didn't score right there. When we come back, we'll have our halftime highlights. And as always, our very entertaining halftime show. We're back with the San Antonio All-Star Game, presented by HEB, coming up right after this.
Welcome to the University Health System Halftime Show.
Welcome back to the Alamodome. Gold leads black 14-9 at the half of the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. You know, earlier this week, a group of All-American players got the opportunity to visit University Hospital. It was a great time, as always, as they lift the spirits of some of the patients and their families, and our cameras were there. Take a look.
So our visit today from the All-American players was just totally inspiring. The young men walked into rooms and really shared their smiles and shook hands and greeted patients and really inspired them to smile. And they brought some light and some joy to not only the patients and family members, but also to our staff members. And we really are encouraged by our sponsorships of community organizations. And so this is one way that organizations can give back as well.
just talking to the kids, you know, trying to pick them up and just make sure they have the best of time today. It's important because, you know, you have to give back what you were given. So, and I mean, God gave us this ability to walk around and live, you know, so just be able to come here and give and talk to kids and give them the best time would be great.
Be the best you are. Be the best you. High five.
It's just cool to see, you know, all these kids that are excited to see us, and then we can have an effect on them and they can have an effect on us. It's not just me, it's a lot of people in the country, and everybody struggles with something, and maybe somebody needs some help, and we're hoping to do that for them. Sometimes we need to look out for each other rather than ourselves, and just going out to these places and being a positive impact, not only on them, but on each other. It's just something cool to see, because I'm gonna go to bed at night tonight, just happy person, knowing I did something better in the world today, knowing I helped somebody's life, you know?
It's a break in the day for the parents, for the patients, and even for staff. The All-American Players just brought some really great light into our facility, and we encourage the community to come visit us and volunteer and show our patients some really great avenues of health and wellness.
Thank you guys so much for coming.
Absolutely. Thank you, bro. It was nice to meet you. Absolutely. Thank you.
It's great. Much more of our University Health System Halftime Show when we come back.
You're watching the University Health System Halftime Show.
And welcome back. All right, the score right now is, let's say, the gold 14, and the black team is, our team black is 9 right now. Great game. This is Russ Bookbinder, president and CEO, San Antonio Sports. You've done it again. Just another fantastic job.
Our team does a great job, and it's a credit to all the high schools. We have over 50 high schools, over 100 players here, recognizing them, the seniors, for what they've done this past year. We've got some good players on the field. It's a competitive game. The teams are balanced, so hopefully the fans are having a great time, and our team's worked hard on it.
Well, you got a nice crowd here that's come out to support. Of course, you have to see the All-American Bowl as well, but there's so much support in South Texas for this. I'm 41st year. It's hard to believe it's been around that long, and you guys have just kind of built it every year now at the Alamodome, and it just seems to be going up and up and up.
We took it over about 6 years ago, moved it to the Dome. HEB joined us full boat to help support it. So the game continues to be respectable and a testament to the players. The coaches love it, the players love it, the fans love it.
Yeah, it's not only an opportunity for the players to shine in front of their family and friends, or for their coaches and recruiters that they might be able to get a scholarship with still, but it's also something that they're going to take away with them for the rest of their lives. They're going to have the memory of spending weeks making friends and making memories.
Absolutely. There's a number of these kids that will play at the collegiate level. Some have commitments already and offers. But some, this is the last look they might get from somebody looking for a player that might fit their program. So it's an opportunity. And to see some of these players play against a higher level of competition really gives whoever is scouting them a different look, a different perspective at them.
That's true. Maybe a more real perspective.
Absolutely.
San Antonio Sports is involved in so much in our community. Could you talk a little bit about, I guess, why y'all are doing what you're doing and some of the things that you're involved with?
Sure. Our mission is to transform the community through the power of sport. And this is one of the events we do, but we really get involved in the community. We have our iPlay After School program, which reaches 1,200 kids in 48 underserved schools in Harlandale and SAISD. We teach sports to those kids every day after school. They learn 5 sports. We hold tournaments for them, but they learn the lessons that sports gives of character, respect, hard work. And the statistics show, proven statistics, that the attendance rates for these kids is much higher than the baseline for their school. So if they're involved in sports, they want to get to school, because if they don't get to school, they can't play.
That's true. That's very true. So by catching them young, you're hoping that you can plant the seeds and teach them those things that are going to help them, not only to stay in school, but to help them in life.
Absolutely. The power of sport is an incredible platform. And we know through research that over 60% of the C-suite executives in this city played sports. We know that 90% of high-level female executives played sports. So it's a very, very powerful thing, and it's not about just the X and the O's. It's about everything that sport teaches you along the way.
Well, Russ, on behalf of San Antonio and South Texas, thank you guys for what you do. We appreciate it. And again, looking forward to the second half. I know you are. And now you're going to be joining me at the end of the game for
Absolutely.
The presentation of these trophies.
We don't know who's going to win yet.
No, we don't.
It's competitive.
It is. All right. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Welcome back to the Alamodome as it's the gold 14, the black 9 here at halftime. Fans having a good time, good close ball game here in the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. And it's time to take a look at our first half highlights. Tobias Weaver, the multi-talented quarterback from Wagner, getting the black into position with a nice run here, but great defensive play by Broderick Howard of Steele High School with the pick. That led to the Gold's first possession, and Dante Hagans from Madison was just fantastic. His first snap took it deep into the black territory, and then Lamonte Crawford scored, put them up top. Again, black trying to get in good field position. Yancey got him down into the position in the big 72. Big fella Luna with a 42-yarder. And then a little trickeration as Bivens hooked up with Haas all the way down to the 5-yard line. And that set up another touchdown. Nia Spencer diving in. Fake punt to Hagans set up Colton Poole's touchdown. Again, a lot of diversity here, running, passing, inside tough running, fast athletes getting to the edge, and stats fairly even when you get to total yardage. 150 for the black, 126 for the gold. First downs are even, penalties and turnovers, the only difference is the gold leads 14-9. It's going to be an electric second half. We're going to let the coaches into your living room and see how they call the plays. Here's some of the terminology. Should be an entertaining second half when we come back to the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. Gold leads the black 14-9. Back with the second half kickoff after this.
Thanks for watching the University Health System Halftime Show. Stay tuned for the second half of tonight's game. The San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game is presented by HEB and sponsored by Whataburger, the U.S. Army, University Health System, CPS Energy, Frost, Ancira, Pizza Hut, Thomas J. Henry, Methodist Healthcare, Hallmark University, Taco Cabana, Vulcan Materials Company, Kielbasa Smoked Meats, Lockaway Storage, Baptist Emergency Hospital, Alamo Real Estate Brokers, iDream SA, UIW, the Children's Hospital of San Antonio, and Knight Office Solutions.
And welcome back to the Alamodome. About ready for the second half kickoff of the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. The Savinol Jackets are representing. Got folks from all over South Texas here, as it's not just the stars from inside the loops, it's all over the viewing area. Hondo, Savinol, just among the communities that are represented here, and everybody getting a chance to play so far and doing well. Gold team will have it first.
as Luna trots out there to kick it off. Ready for our Hallmark University second half kickoff. Team Black getting fired up on the sidelines. Coach Mike Hernandez will be spending some time with Coach Mike Norman on the gold sideline this half as well, as the gold team has the lead. Ethan Sill from Smithson Valley is back along with Nicholas Proctor from Alamo Heights to receive the kick from Luna. It's going to be Sill from Smithson Valley right at the nine. Return set up to the middle. He tries to use his speed to get to the outside, but he stood up in a nice tough tackle by the Black team's Kavon Barnes from Wagner. We'll see who the gold team trots out there for their first reps of the second half. Reed Anderson from Alamo Heights got the start, and he'll start the second half off as well. He's got Nick Proctor, his teammate from the Mules, out there with him. And his tailback is Yamani Crawford from Cole, and this is an HEB first down as Anderson keeps and goes out of bounds for a gain of about two. Pushed out of bounds by Waters from Judson. Sets up second down and seven for the gold squad. More of a tight formation with Crawford in the backfield. Pass all the way as Anderson looks over the middle and deep, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Black squad. That's Hilario Gomez from Central Catholic, and that young man has made more than a few plays here today. Gomez has shown speed at times, really some big hits, and now an athletic interception by the Button from Central Catholic. Nice job.
Nice job indeed, Don. I'm joined by Alamo Heights coach and coach of our team goal, Mike Norman. How are you, sir?
Doing all right. I mean, we're ahead right now, so I'm doing better than I would be if we weren't.
So how's the game progressing so far as what you tried to go through the week with and work with the kids on?
Well, it's going like we thought. I mean, we put a lot on in a week, and you know, we're making mistakes. The kids are making a lot of plays. There's a lot of good, great athletes out here making great plays. And so far, it's been really fun.
All right, so you have some trick plays?
We've run a few already.
Yeah? We got some more?
We still might have a few in our back pocket. we probably have a few more in our back pocket.
So, great year for Alamo Heights once again, and congratulations on your success over the years. I know you have a few of your players. With your starting quarterback, for one. I mean, that must be nice starting the game with someone who knows your system and knows what you're trying to do.
Yeah, and he's been great throughout, you know, the week, him and Mackey. Been sort of kind of the defensive and offensive captains on the sideline, being able to help the kids out, knowing what we're trying to do.
All right, so if it's okay, we're going to be kind of maybe helping you call some of the plays at some point, or helping your offensive coordinator call them.
Okay.
Not that you need the help, but it gives us something to do.
Well,
it's fun.
We need to get a little more, so yeah, we might need some help here in a little bit.
All right, Coach, thank you so much.
I appreciate it.
All right, thanks. Back to you guys.
All right, Bernard Danke on the run from Marshall. He has been another standout player in this game. 16-yard pickup for him is Tobias Weaver, the signal caller from Wagner, back in taking the snaps in the shotgun. Hands it to Danke again, and Danke carries tacklers with him about 5 yards. He'll get forward progress all the way close to the 27. But can't tell you how impressed we've been with young Bernard Danke. 1,300 yards and 17 touchdowns. Unanimous all-district player. And he is showing, if you didn't see the Marshall Rams this year, you missed out on this young man, because he's one of the standouts here today. Second down and seven for Team Black. Weaver over the middle, and that's almost intercepted. It was read well by Josiah Gutierrez-Smith from Warren. He just didn't come up with it, but he knew exactly where it was going, and he almost made the play. Good defensive coverage there by the Gold squad. A little run pass option, and Weaver pulled the string on it. A little confusion here by Team Black. Play clock down to a 10, though, so they have plenty of time. Three receivers to the left, and third and seven. Weaver keeps, and he is tripped up. But he's got the stick, and they'll move the chains. First down, as Josiah Gutierrez-Smith from Warren makes the tackle again. If I'm a scout out here today, there's a couple of kids who, if they don't have rides, they've definitely piqued my interest, and Josiah Gutierrez-Smith is one of those. As we move into the Knight Office Solutions red zone. Inside handoff. That's Brandon Adams from Sam Houston. Haven't really been able to see what he's able to do there on the edge yet, as Maki Carabin from Alamo Heights makes the tackle. Sets up second down and nine. As Weaver's going to check his wristband. Hayden Haas split to the left. Ruiz to the right. Ruiz is that dangerous receiver from Harlandale. Instead, it's an inside handoff across the 25 down to the 24. That's Jalen Hastings out of John Jay High School. Play with Jacob Zeno there. Zeno's going to be going to Baylor to play quarterback. They made for a heck of a 1-2 punch there at John Jay. Third down, about six. Big conversion opportunity here. Weaver fires out in the flat, and it's dropped. That was intended for Anaya Spencer, who's got a touchdown here today. And had he caught that, he would have definitely gotten the first down, if not a touchdown. Instead, they'll run out the kicking team, and Luna, who's already good from 42 today. We'll see if he's good from 32. Same kick that he had in the first half, just 10 yards shorter. Good snap, good hold. Kick's good, plenty deep, and through. Cuts the lead to two, it's 14-12. Gold team, and the gold team will have it when we come back. 8:09 to play here in the Dome.
Hey, Don.
Who we got? Who's the coordinator from Alamo Heights?
Blaine Ellis.
Blaine Ellis.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, just tell him to keep it clean. We're going to keep the mic in his face. Let him call the plays.
Let me see if Higgins is going to go in. If Higgins is going to go in, I wanted to interview him before he went in, but we had to go to the break. So let me see if he's in. Hang on. You're not going in? Okay. I got Dante Higgins I want to talk to first.
Okay.
Welcome back. I'm joined by Madison High School's Dante Higgins. How you doing, son?
We're doing good.
That was a great run earlier. How did you feel when you were out there? How's it feel being out there with all these top-notch athletes?
It it feels good to play with these other athletes from around the city. And that run, it was just, I saw no one back there, so I had to cut it up real quick.
So you're a commit to UIW. What made you choose them?
Just what they're building there, and it's in my hometown, so I wanted to stay close to family.
I see. I see. And I hear you had a basketball game earlier today.
Yes, sir. We played Reagan, beat them by 30.
How'd you do?
I did good.
All right. Well, listen, I'll let you get back to the game. Thank you for joining us, and good luck in your future.
Thank you.
All right.
All right. Thanks, Mike. A little onside didn't work there. So the Gold Squad will run out their offense near midfield. Blaine Ellis is the offensive coordinator at Alamo Heights. Tyler Mills is going to play quarterback. So we'll try to get some of those calls with Mike and Blaine Ellis. Be first down right at the 47-yard line. Mills is a young quarterback from Marion. Again, they're a 3A team. He was second team All-State. Put up some really big numbers in his career there. And that's Colton Poole, who has had a really good game here today. Has a touchdown. And he's got a 10-yard gain there. And then a late flag, may have been a face mask. We're at the very end of it.
All right. Hey, guys, I'm joined by the offensive coordinator. Could you introduce yourself for me?
Randy Osborne.
All right, Randy. What are you looking at right now? What kind of situation and what
right
kind
now
of play?
They're playing a lot of man coverage on us and keeping they're keeping a lot of people in the box. We're trying to get some we're going to try and get some things down the field here in just a minute.
All right. So on this particular play, what are you going to be calling?
Well, I got to see what the penalty is first.
Okay.
It's going to be 15 face mask on the end of the run, in my guess.
After the play was over, dead ball, unnecessary rough number 56. Of the goal team. They made the line to gain, so we're back 15 yards, and it's first down.
All right, so I was wrong.
15 yards back,
first down.
First and 10?
First and 10.
Oh, first and 10.
They made the line to gain, and then the dead ball penalty, so yes, it's first down.
Okay, Coach, so what do you think?
We're going to look at we're going to throw the ball down the field right here. We're going to look at a double post here.
Double post, down the field.
Wide receivers in the game right now. Looks like we've got Jackson Allen from Marion, which makes sense because his quarterback is Taylor Mills, so that's a target that he's familiar with. And on the near side, you got Jordan Smith from Brennan. So we'll see those two outside receivers, see if they run the post. And more if he can protect him.
Good protection.
He threw the post, but they ran the out. So that's just miscommunication. Second down, let's listen in.
Let's go, Ram. Ram.
Got a ram. What does that
42,
mean, Coach?
42. It's trips formation.
Trips formation?
Yeah, 42.
Trips formation, 42. They're going to run the ball, he says.
All right. Quarterback called, quarterback draw. He's got a running back in there.
He's got a running back in there, yeah.
It's Poole from Bernie, who's been a tough runner today. And they run it right up the middle. Maybe a yard or two. He's going to set up third down and long. All right, got to be creative here. Let's listen.
All right, so third and long. Looks like they're changing the personnel a little bit here.
Number 7, his helmet came off due to play. He must leave the field for one play.
Oh, helmet came off. He's got to leave.
All right, Coach, what was that?
It's a passing play. We got a little cross with a little curl on the other side of it and a post over the top.
Who's your primary on this one?
What's that?
Who's your primary receiver?
We're going to read tight end to the dig to the post.
All right. Tight end to the dig to the post. Here we go.
Threw it to the tight end, complete. Got to punt the football.
four.
It's like a roughing the passer here.
Seven. They keep the drive alive.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 46. It's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, an automatic first down.
We're good.
Coach Norman's calling a Trey 46. And I will find out what that is in just a sec. Trey 46.
46. Stretch play this way.
Run play.
Out of a trips. Yes.
All right. So the four back in the six hole.
Yes.
Got it.
Wide stretch here. But he can look to the cutback if the nine, if that nine technique gets upfield.
All right, so it's a running play all the way here.
Try to stretch it out a little bit.
Try to stretch it out. And Imani Crawford is upended. Nice play on the defensive side of the ball by number 21 on the black squad. And that's Darren Taylor from Seguin at 23 as well. Carlos Reyes from Central Catholic.
Okay, coach.
Second down and long.
Coverage the short side of the field.
Take man a shot down
short side. Yeah.
Okay, you got man coverage on the left side. Gotcha. Okay. Going long, Don.
One-on-one this side of the ball. Now he rolled the safety over there, though. That's going to be an interesting throw. Looking this way all the way. Now he's going deep. One-on-one. And threw it too wide out of bounds.
Looks like that play unfolded just a little slow.
And that'll set up third and long for Taylor Mills.
Coaching conference going on here.
Yeah, they're calling Dante Higgins' name. And Mike, you may want to ask him, what's it like to when you have different personnel? You know, the one kid compared to another, like Higgins.
Okay, I will do that.
Because he's got a special, special player here.
Okay,
we're going to throw screens on the outside, but the quarterback can run quarterback draw if he counts five in the box.
Okay, here we go.
And somebody wanted a timeout.
Timeout, gold.
All right, looks like gold took in a timeout.
We'll take it with them when we come back. Gold team still on the move. They lead it 14-12 here at the Dome. We're back and we're checking out those big guys. Carson Ferris is 300 pounds and he keeps his weight up with that honey butter chicken biscuit there at Whataburger. Big number 78. One kid said he drank 5 gallons of milk a day. Here's Higgins, look at his speed. That makes all the difference in the world. So Mike, my question to the gold coaches is, why isn't he in there all the time?
Because it is an all-star game.
I know, everybody's got to play, right? But smart call to put him in there on third down.
Absolutely, absolutely. And he just truly has another gear right now.
Reminds us of Justin Stockton when he played for Steele and dominated this game. As you see, our Alamo State Real Estate Breakers.
We got a counter, a little counter play coming back this way.
Smile camp.
Guard, and it could be center here to Texas. And tight end are going to pull this way.
The counter play to the kid from Cole. He could score. Broke the tackle, still on his feet inside the 10. Imani Crawford from Cole already has a touchdown. Carlos Reyes from Central Catholic making the tackle. And this is the combination that was so dangerous in the first quarter when you got Higgins at quarterback and Crawford playing the tailback. Both really, really fast players on the edge.
Okay, what we got?
He's got a power play. A little power up inside, little zone play.
Zone read here.
Zone read, there we go.
Crawford. And the big front for the black team held there. Seth Jaquis making the stop from Churchill. Whatever the three is.
Quick.
Three
here.
Quick.
Yeah, 90. We're going to try and take
number 11.
Yeah, we're going to try and hit a little fade right here, number 11.
Little fade, number 11.
Wide though.
He's by himself on the top of your screen. Got single coverage. Look at Hagans get loose. Finally brought down for a sack. And great defensive job by their Carlos Reyes, number 23, and Eric Holman from Mack, both there in the backfield.
Okay. Big third down here.
And just Hagans had nowhere to go. So third and goal.
Bringing out the tight end now. That's you.
What do we got, Mike?
What do we got, Coach?
We're going to run a little fake corner here and back to the post with a single, with the number two right here, receiver.
All right. We're looking for Brent Malone. And it's a fake, and then he's going to try to throw the post. He's got him now. Back in the end zone. He just overshot him. Had him a little bit early. He had to roll out. And what he did, he had to buy some extra time. So now they'll send out the kicking unit and see if they can put three more on the board.
What is it like, Coach, having all this talent on one team?
If we had like a couple weeks to work with, it'd be awesome. It's great to work with all these kids, though. Great kids, all have great work ethics. But, yeah, that's a lot of talent out here. So it'd be great to have. I'd take half of them. Take just a few of them. It'd be awesome.
I understand that. All right, here we go.
Here's Elian Valdez from 36. And it's no good. It was long enough, just pulled it to the left.
Thank you.
So it's still a one possession game. Black can take the lead with a field goal. Mike Hernandez will flip-flop sidelines and we'll take you into the black huddle when we come back. 3:56 to go in the third. Welcome back to the CPS Energy Cheer Cam. The Unicorn Cheerleaders having a great time. Congratulations for them for winning the contest to be out here. As Carson Valverde from Tyvee on first down goes deep, and it's almost caught off the deflection by Hayden Haas. Instead, it's incomplete. Good coverage by Micah Garcia from Jefferson. Nice. Go deep on first down. Set up second down for Carson. Second and 10. This little swing here to Valverde. He wants a corner. He's going to run right into Mike Hernandez. I've never seen Mike move so fast. Usually he's just sitting there eating on whatever food we have that night. Here's Carson's numbers. 144 for 207 in 2 years there. And he ran for almost 1,500 or over 1,500 yards. Very versatile player. Made himself a note when he was a freshman in high school that he wanted to play in the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game, and look at him. He's here following in the footsteps of Johnny Manziel at Kerrville Tyvee, playing quarterback for the Antlers and playing in this All-Star Game. Good for him. And swing it to the other side. He's in trouble here. And he's dropped, balls out. Goal team scoop. Goal team score. Touchdown. Goal. Jamie Ferguson from Madison on the scoop and score. Have to see who got there to knock it out. Just good pursuit. Couldn't see the jersey number on the young man who made the play. He had a blue helmet, met him in from MacArthur. Could have been Monty Cluck from Bernie. Had to see that one more time, but it was a great back pursuit. Stayed with it. And Ferguson gets the turnover cape. And the gold is out in front, 21-12. was backside pursuit by number 34. Great rush, and it's Patrick Rhodes from Cole who knocked it out. I like the fact that the
shout out gold team.
Gold team's
shout
got
out
the
gold team. Shout out gold team.
Gold team's got the 21 or the
Madison, you know how we coming. Yeah, we
got the turnover cape for the turnover king. It caused a couple of them. Valverde will go back to receive this kickoff. Kenyon Morgan back there with him. And the black team is going to need to do something special here to get back in this football game. Here's Morgan. Got a middle return set up. He's got space. Needs a block. And trips and falls right at the 44-yard line trying to make the cutback. Had the chance to make a very special play and just lost his footing. Did a great job following his blockers. And then lost the handle and lost the footing. We've got some new personnel in for the black squad.
I'm not calling the footing call right now. Another legend. Another legend to the hat. Quinn? Off the guy right here.
Jordan Choate from Jay in at receiver.
Coach? Right now, I understand you're calling the plays.
Okay. Here is Hastings going airborne. Hey, Bivens out there.
Bubble to the left. A little bubble pass to the right. Okay. Bubble pass to the left. Okay. Excuse me. Is that the, oh, you got your plays on there.
Yeah, right.
Oh, I see.
I'll tell you what, the gold team is doing a heck of a job running to the football. As Anaya Spencer was the receiver on that one. Jalen Hastings back in.
We're gonna run the buck sweep to the left to run. Okay,
he's going to the left. Adrian Ronhell in at quarterback for the first time from Southwest Legacy.
So getting his first we're going to run a sweep to the left.
Yes, yes, a buck sweep. Uh-oh.
Almost had another turnover, and they do, I think. No.
An inside run.
Of course, a new school for Southwest Legacy. Adrian Ronhell, first year of varsity play there, 5'11", 170. Had six touchdowns, four interceptions.
All right, so call the, what you call it, coach?
Sprint out, get the quarterback out of the pocket, see if we can't make a play in space, give him a chance.
Pretty tough with that core of linebackers they have.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Nice.
Okay, Mike, I got a play for him if he wants one.
I think it's fourth down.
Oh, I thought that was third.
Okay.
Next series. I got a play to get the black team back in the game.
Okay.
Brandon Adams in space.
Actually, 26. We're running a 26.
It's going to be a stop route. It's going to be 7 yards, back to five.
Help out.
Stop route. And then hopefully put an athlete against an athlete, make a move.
Okay.
7 yard stop route. There he is, Bivens. And good coverage by the gold defense. Kenny Bivens picks up about five.
Well,
good spot on the field to fake.
We were talking
it.
About this. Just look at the list of linebackers that you've got. One, two, three, four All-Staters,
and the other one's going to Harvard.
Well, that's pretty dang impressive. Not only are they athletes, but that means they're smart too. So that's hard.
That's
hard,
a dangerous combination.
It is hard to beat.
Yes, it is.
Proctor from Alamo Heights back to receive the punt. What a kick. No wonder that kid's an all-star. And he gets it out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Tip of the cap to 19 there. That's Nick Falzone from Churchill. Fantastic job. Time to look at our Scholar Athlete of the Year. You know, all season long, Mike Hernandez has been bringing you the different Scholar Athletes of the Week. But the winner of the $10,000 scholarship goes to Nicholas McCann from Harlan, home of the Hawks. He's a diver, and he's going to the University of Tennessee to continue his diving career. And Vulcan Materials Company helping him out with $10,000. Congratulations to Nicholas McCann, our Vulcan Materials Company Scholar Athlete of the Year. Great job, young man. Reed Anderson from Alamo Heights back in at quarterback. Gold team backed up inside their own 10. A little jet sweep to the right-hand side from Raul Augusto from South San. He's got a couple.
Augusto on the carry.
Sets up second down in about 6. Straight drop, contested play. He thinks he's got an interception. Hilario Gomez, who's done everything today for the black defense. But he comes up smiling. He tried to fool the officials there. That's the end of the third quarter. Gold team on top. We got more when we come back. Stick around for the fourth quarter of the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game, presented by HEB. Welcome back, it's 21-12. One of the great rock albums of all time, by the way. Third down and 7. Gold team running a little pitch. Black team snuffing it out. It's gonna be a loss on the play. Colton Poole had no room to work. Canyon Lake player making a stop. Good for Grayson Lee, 29. Saw the Canyon Lake cheerleaders here. I told you earlier, we got kids from just about every school in the area representing their schools here. Find some pretty good athletes. Brandon Richard back to receive the punt, but it is a shank. It's going backwards. And it's going to be down at the 20. That's where the black team will have it. You see the personnel out there. Great chance for the black team to get right back in this ball game. Still a lot of time, 11-14, 21-12 our score. See the personnel out there. Bivens, Beavers, Tobias Weaver. And then you got Danky. So this is their first group. Slant route. Beavers wasn't even looking for it. Hit him in the back of the head, I think. That's just when you only have 1 week to work with guys. Confusion. You see the quadrant of offensive coaches there from the Judson coaching staff. Inside handoff to Danky. And he's got about 4 before he's brought down. Brent Malone. Malone from Brandeis making the tackle. That young man is a kid we keep talking about that's going to Harvard. And that sets up third down and about seven. And it's Tobias Weaver from Wagner. Danke again, straight ahead. Close to this marker. I'm not sure he's got it. It's going to be close. It'll set up fourth and a few inches if they don't stop to measure here. We've got an injury down on the field. Injured gold team player. We'll take the break and let you know how he is when we come back. Welcome back to the Alamodome, 21-12. Our score, gold team leads it. Black team driving, fourth and one. The measurement was short. Injury was not serious. And see what happens here with Dakey and Tobias Weaver here on fourth and one. Two very talented backs. Dakey pretty physical. He runs it and gets it easily. First down, that'll set first and goal.
That's good for a team black first down.
7 points here makes it a field goal difference, so we could have a fantastic finish here at the Alamo Dome. They send Bivens over into the slot. Making a nice tackle for the gold squad out in space is again Josiah Gutierrez Smith from Warren. He's been fantastic.
Hey Don, I've got Carson Valverde here, quarterback from Kerrville Tyvee this year. Congratulations, son, on unanimous District 27-5A MVP selection.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thanks so much.
So I heard something about you. I heard that as a little boy, you wrote down on a paper somewhere that your goal was to actually play in this game someday. Is that true?
Yes, sir. Freshman year, we had our starting quarterback at the time, Kay Dial, played in this game. And I came to that game and watched him. That's one of my goals that I had. Then I said I want to play in the All-Star game. And every since sophomore year when I started at quarterback, Every Monday night, I'd write down goals for the week for Friday night's game, and that's one of the goals that I added to my desk where I keep my goal list. And so once Coach Jones, our head coach, brought me into the office and told me, gave me the letter and said, you got picked to play in the game, I felt good about myself and accomplished the goal. So
that's good. Congratulations. That's wonderful. So what's next for you? What are your plans?
Hopefully go play college somewhere. I want to get a UMHB. They just won a national championship, so I mean, good program down there, and hopefully get to go play there. So,
all right, well, good luck and God bless to you, son. All right,
thank you.
Back to you.
For those of you who don't know, UMHB is the University of Mary Hardin Baylor. They have a very good football program there. National champs. Good for Carson. Luna's going to trot out here, try another long field goal. About 37 yards. He's good from 42 today. Missed from 32. Good snap, good hold. Kick, may have to hurry. Got there. Looked short from here, but he got it. And the black team puts three more on the board. 21-15 our score, so a good close game here as we come down to the finish. We're back, it's the Ansira.com Smile Cam. Fans of all ages out here today, little kids having a great time. We got a close football game. As Jamonte Crawford is back deep to receive the kick. And the Central Catholic fans representing Carlos Reyes and company. Very happy with the way their guy's doing it today. Crawford trying to get outside. good speed, not going to get there. That's Nicholas Proctor from Alamo Heights. And the Gold Squad needs to answer now, leading by just six. Too many times we've been in this game where we've seen blowout scores. This one's very competitive. Both teams with a chance to win here going into the final minutes. 7:55 to play. Dante Hagans, though, back in at quarterback for the Gold. Seth Jaquist lining up on the left end, big number 99 in black. It's a good one-on-one matchup there. Good run up the middle. Oh, first down. Colton Poole, chance at an MVP here. Colton Poole's doing a nice job along with Dante Hagans. Parents of 73, having a great time. Antonio Gonzalez from Floresville. Hagans has a first down, 42-yard line for the Gold team. Hands to Poole, and he's going nowhere. Again, blown up by the Black Squad. Kyle Colby there. First man there may have been Hilario Gomez again from Central Catholic, who's been everywhere. Canyon Lake cheerleaders, one of the cheer squads to win the contest to be here today. Second down. And about 14 here. Hagans brought down by his shirt. No, he keeps his feet. Still buying time. He may run a mile before he gets 5 yards. And a big crackback block. Official throws the flag on it. Look pretty clean from here. Dante Hagans probably runs 75, 80 yards to pick up 10. But it's coming back because of that block.
Illegal block in the back. Number 52, offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay, second down.
Here's a look at it. It's after Hagans turns and comes all the way to the other side. Oh, they got that one, okay. There's another one coming up here that was clean. They called it way on the other far sideline. And now it looks like we have a timeout. We'll take it with them. Gold Squad calling timeout. They lead at 21-15. Welcome back to CPS Energy Cheer Camp. Canyon Lake cheerleaders cheering wildly along with those from New Braunfels. Congratulations to the cheer squads that earned the right to be here. 6:21 to go. Gold team with a 6-point lead and the football and a second down and 18. And here's Hagans. Fires into the flat. Coming up to make a tackle. Nice job by number 7, Brandon Richard from San Antonio Christian. Ryan Escobedo from Legacy of Educational Excellence on the catch. Tell you what, Brandon Richard has proven he can play. Young man out of San Antonio Christian. Didn't blink here facing top-notch Division I talent. He's shown he's got the speed, tackling ability, made a great play in coverage. Hagan's straight drop, wants to go deep, fires deep over the middle, got a man. There was some contact, no flag flies, as that was intended for Jamont McLean out of Edison. Javon Barnes from Wagner back there, and Xavier Player from Steele, one of the best players in town. This is Whataburger player profile. He likes the patty melt and lemonade. 6 foot cornerback. Great season there. Steven Ruiz from Harlandale back to receive the punt. Steven Ruiz is a kid we had a couple of different times on TNL that was just really electric. Calls for the fair catch, takes it. And the black team will have 5:17 to go ahead. And Mike, you know the play I want. I got the game-winning play for the black squad. Brandon Adams in space.
I told Coach Mack, and he just laughed and walked away. I don't know what that means, Don.
You stated twice.
So it's all coming down to this drive, it looks like. Coach, got some secrets that you've been holding back and secret plays?
We're going to rely on the 300-pound kids up front and try to run the ball right down the
there he is, 13. 13's my guy.
Probably do it again if it works. If not, I think we're going to throw the football.
All right, here we go.
That's my guy right there. Got to get him in space, though.
Buddy Ryan battle right here.
It is. It is. So Don is asking. Don is asking that if you can get Brandon Adams on that bubble. That
he's
bubble
gone.
Screen. Yeah.
Let me go
in that space.
Yeah. Let me walk right down and I will see if we can get that done for him. Because Don's my boy.
Okay. He's gonna jump right on that, Don.
There he is. That's incomplete pass, isn't it? Oh, they've got a flag. They get his face mask?
I couldn't tell. It was on the other side of the field. They're talking it over, looks like. Here we go.
Intentional grounding. Number 10, black. Spot foul, loss of down. Third down.
Oh, they're in trouble now.
That's it. Third down and 8. All right, Coach, what you thinking?
Let me see where. I'll let the music build the suspense real quick.
I love Sean McCollum. Not taking it too seriously.
I'm going to guess we're going to get the ball to a fast kid.
That's deep, Coach.
They've got the Judson kid in the slot, Taylor at the top. Little pump and go. Flag flies. Valverde's going to run it. It's going to be a hold back on the black team, I believe.
Well, they got a first down if the penalty doesn't wipe it out.
Officiating crew settling it out, sorting it out. Figure out where the spot
holding
was.
Holding of the offense, number 75. 10-yard penalty from the spot, the previous spot, and replay second down.
Hey, congratulations to Brandeis. They're the winner of our $5,000 band grant, courtesy of the Children's Hospital of San Antonio and Chris's Health all year long. We had you vote for those really impressive bands that we brought to you all season long. None stronger than Brandeis, the winners of our $5,000 band grant winner.
Coach Williams, what'd you call on this?
Everybody vertical. We're going to see if we can get either a big play or a pass interference.
Kind of a Hail Mary kind of a thing.
Basically.
Four verticals.
They playing deep coverage. There's really nothing you can do. We don't have a play for 3rd and 50.
Got to buy him some time. The rush is the big thing here. Valverde needs a block over here. Almost got there, but enough to go for it here on fourth. Got plenty of time. Did a good job making it up. Xavier Player on the tackle. So now you got fourth down and about seven. That's manageable. And I'm telling you, put my guy in 13 and give him the ball, they'll get it. Fourth down.
This may be it right here. Coach, what'd you call?
We're going to go in motion, try to send the back. Two guys are going to split. We're going to try to get the back up the middle of those two receivers.
Okay.
Hopefully this works. It's been a big play for us.
Go, 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 go!
Giving him a chance. And he caught it. Tie goes to the offensive receiver. Anaya Spencer went up and got the football. Nice play by Carson Valverde from Tyler to give him a chance from Kerrville Tyvee. At least give him a shot at it. He went out, high pointed the football.
Donnie was
2 yards and a first down.
Donnie was talking about this just a little while ago. This was his dream. This was something that was he had been working towards for years, and here he is. That was a huge play.
An HEB first down. 3 minutes to go. Black Squad still has life. Valverde keeps. Valverde's speed. Valverde inside the 6 yard line. Ethan Sill with the tackle.
Yep.
Black Squad now knocking on the door. 19 yard gain. Bernard Hanke.
Okay, coach, so you got a first down. You still got a lot of time left. What you got?
Pull all the big boys to the left and see if the little man can get behind them.
There you go. Hanke behind the big fellas. There you go. Got Brandon Brown leading the way. Touchdown, touchdown. Wow, what a drive by the Black Squad. Fourth down. Carson Valverde keeps the drive alive. And then a smart call to go behind all those 300-pounders and let Marshall's Bernard Hanke do the rest. Game's all tied up. Luna to give the Black Squad the lead. Kick is good, and it's 22-21 Black. Good times at the Alamodome, huh, Mike?
John, I'm going to go to the other side.
All right.
Because I want to be there and see what Coach Norman has up his sleeve.
I think it would be wise to go with Dante Hagans.
I would agree with you. There's 2:47 left, and there's still plenty of time, especially if they can get some decent field position off the kickoff. Remember, a field goal does it.
Yep. Got to get them into range. What a drive by Carson Valverde and Kerrville Tyvee.
He just took over the game, and I'm so happy for him. Just knowing that this was so important for him to have this happen, to be able to play in this game, and then to have this kind of moment, that's fantastic.
Yeah, it was a rough, it looked like he was having a rough day early. He fumbled earlier and didn't seem to get into a rhythm with that offense. In fact, both of the plays that went for big yardage were broken plays that he turned something out of nothing, so a lot of individual effort by him to find a way. Nicholas Proctor from Alamo Heights on the return. He's brought down short of the 30 at about the 27-yard line, so here we go. 2 minute drill time for the Gold Squad, and we'll see who they run out there. Now, there's a couple of different schools of thought here as we look at the collision of the game. He took that big hit, Valverde, earlier. Hung on to the ball, but it was Broderick Howard who
scooped and scored earlier for our play of the game.
Okay, Coach. Offensive coordinators make their money in drives like this. What do we have?
We just got a little run play on. Hope we play a little soft here first. Try and get some established here.
All right. Hey, let's go.
Get about three. They've gone back to Reed Anderson at quarterback. So it's that familiarity of Proctor and Anderson, both of Alamo Heights.
Devontae
Crawford from Cole, their starting unit. And Anderson fires in the flat, and it's intercepted. It was a little high, and Javon Barnes jumped the route. The Judson Rocket saved the day for the Black Squad. Now still 2:14 to go. The Gold has one timeout. But Black will have a chance to put it away as Anderson airmailed it, and Javon Barnes from Wagner did a great job of extending to make the play. There's the money bags. They're making the money play.
Yeah, you see.
Athletes make the big plays.
There's Jalen Hastings in space. Jalen Hastings from Jay. Touchdown, Black. What a comeback for Team Black.
Boy, what a turn of events here. All of a sudden, Team Black just wakes up and explodes.
Oh, you see what we saw from Hastings all year. The ability to change direction and not lose any speed. A very important extra point here. And he's got no holder. Who's holding? Somebody get out there and hold. We may have to burn a timeout.
Timeout, Judson.
And they do. We'll take it with them. 28-21 Black. They're trying to add to it when we come back. Huh?
I say Valverde.
We can't give it to it. I'd say Valverde.
I say Valverde too.
Huh?
Valverde.
Kickers can't be MVPs.
I don't know. Kerrville time.
Hey, I'm there.
I'm ready.
Did you call a play though?
I called a bunch of plays.
Oh, yeah?
That's why we exploded.
Yeah, those last.
Yeah.
Are we going to miss this? We're back in the Alamodome as the Black team tries to top the Gold. And the extra point was good, so it's 29-21 with 2:08 to play. Jalen Hastings flexing after scoring a touchdown.
There you go.
And the Gold will have another shot. And remember, if Dante Higgins has anything to say about it, they'll have a shot.
Hey, you've got a very happy bunch here on the Team Black side here. Let's see if the Gold team can put something together.
All right, back deep for the Gold squad. Ethan Sill. Nicholas Proctor. It's Proctor from Alamo Heights. He's got the 10.
He gets the edge. And he's brought down from behind. Danke from Marshall on the tackle. Good field position with 2 minutes to go. They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion to send this to overtime. And they do run in Hagans. So here we go. Arguably the most talented player on the field at quarterback for team goal. Hagans throws it out in the flat. It's caught. Colton Poole from Bernie gets out of bounds, stops the clock. 1:52, second down, and about five. Signaling the play in. 20 left on the play clock. Hagans pumps the flat, now throws it, incomplete, clock stops. Looking for Poole out there, didn't have it. Again, these guys have only worked together for a week. And our last Whataburger player profile is that of Johnny Zamora. He likes the honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich. I never tried it. But I see the commercials, it looks good. Third and four. Hagans, quarterback draw. Gets the first down and gets out of bounds. Smart play, and you can see how slow the game is for him. Just plays at a different speed. Gold team very much alive with him in the ball game. Picks up the first down. Hagan, straight drop, running now. Now finds a receiver, caught and out of bounds. Stops the clock inside the 40 with 1:33 left. Eric Rasko of Warren, who's a fantastic player. Hadn't seen much of him tonight, but he's really one of the better players in town. Second down and five. Gold team still alive. On the move, Hagans throws it and it's dropped. Looked like it was gonna be caught in double coverage. Rasko can't hang on to that one, sets up third down. Hagans, inside handoff, Colton Poole inside the 25 down to the 20 yard line, picks up the first down on third and five. Still 1:21 to go in a lifetime. First and 10, Hagans on a quarterback keep. Getting to the outside, getting near a first down. Something tells me it's gonna come down to a two-point conversion. We've got a player down.
Injury timeout.
And they'll take an injury timeout. Once again, a big congratulations to all the cheerleaders that won here, Marshall and Bandera, New Braunfels and Canyon Lake. All part of our cheer challenge. Second and one. And there's a bust. Hagans now finds a man. Touchdown, Gold! Rasko from Warren brings him to within two. So that'll set up a two-point conversion try to tie the game. They've got a timeout. They're not taking it. Now they will. We'll take it with them. We're coming back with more. So the black team holds. Seth Jaquist staying home. They did what they could, run their most talented guy, but Seth Jaquist of Churchill right there to snuff it out. Mike, what do you think? Who's your MVP? So with 59 seconds to go, the black squad just needs to snap it twice. The gold team with no more timeouts. And Dante Hagans, after leading the gold team all the way down to what appeared to be a chance of a tying two-point conversion, couldn't quite finish it. Thanks to some great defense by the black squad.
Just truly a great game. What a comeback. What a way to both teams to be hanging in there and not give up. And this game has been one of the better ones that I know you and I have done.
Oh, absolutely. Gold still with the chance of a...
Comes the onside kick for
onside
sure.
Onside kick right now. And here's the thing about onside kicks when you start talking about all-star games. I mean, you don't have time and practice for hands teams and all of that. So sometimes they even don't allow these kind of things in all-star games because you can't prepare for them.
Yeah, so they're playing this pretty much straight up. I understand college rules. If there would have been a tie, they would have gone into overtime. So, I mean, this is a real game with all the same issues that you'd have and all the same decisions. So we'll see. There's still a chance. As you say, these are great athletes. They're all playing here, and anything can happen, especially when you have this caliber of athlete on the field.
Oh, absolutely. And especially when you have the, you know, the advantage of here. It's like backyard football. Right now, there's not a lot of guys who put in time practice. You know, the best thing to do here, kick it right down to about where that hole is, where the Alamodome logo is, that burgundy logo at about the 30. Just punch it down there and try to beat him to that space because there's nobody down there.
I agree. Up, they're going.
Oh, he got it!
I don't believe that.
It went 10 yards, and Ethan still got it. The gold team lives. A field goal will win it. And they've got 59 seconds to do so. Thank you.
Devon Barnes, who's had such great hands, had that interception that led to a black team score late. Reed Anderson back in, it's his rep. Has a chance to lead his squad down the field. Straight drop, looking for his man, Proctor had him. Now boots out, fires, and that one is caught, but I believe he was out of bounds. And he was. Took 10 seconds off the clock. Ryan Escobedo, the intended receiver.
Okay, Don, we're back. Had a little bit of a difficulty with the microphone.
No worries.
Is anybody sweating over here, Coach?
What's that?
Is anybody sweating over here?
Yeah, you hate it when it. You know, when you don't capitalize on an onside kick, now you've got the pressures on. You know, they're talented, so we'll see what happens.
Second down and 10 for Reed Anderson. Fires, has a man, it's caught. First down. Tick, tick, tick. Doesn't get the first down. It's forward momentum may have. They stopped the clock.
It's been fun and exciting. It's a great way to end the year.
Now they say wind it. Clock runs at 31. Anderson deep. Has a man in. Incomplete. Intended for Eric Rasko. Just a little underthrown. Rasko had to come back for it. That wasn't Rasko, that was Jordan Smith from Brennan.
Don, I'm just looking at some of the players on Team Black. They're gassed. They are gassed.
I bet. They've been out there a long time.
Yes, they have.
Listen to the crowd. Channing defense. Anderson. Fires over the middle. Incomplete. What a throw. And almost coming down with it is Nicholas Proctor, his teammate from Alamo Heights, who made a great effort, just couldn't quite bring it in. Oh, just a little bit overthrown. Third down and 10. 24 seconds. Two plays for the goal.
How close do you think they have to get?
They got 10. It's third and 10, you know, to get a first down. But I imagine they're trying to score now.
Anderson looking left again. Straight fly route. Got a man. Caught. Touchdown. Goal. Eric Rasko from Warren High School. And he's being mobbed by his gold teammates. How fun is that?
Wow.
Reed Anderson throwing a dime. Rasko ran past everybody. Great throw, great catch. And Rasko has two touchdown catches late. And he makes a case for MVP.
Delay of game on the offense. The 5-yard penalty still due to try.
Celebration penalty by the Gold Squad, and that could be important. Because the Black Squad may have something left to say, too. Taking an hour and a half to kick the extra point here. They've decided that one does you no good, so they're going to go for two, even with that penalty. And
Anderson. Almost had it intercepted instead. It'll be a 4-point gold lead with 18 seconds to go.
Don, you know, anytime you get this kind of group of athletes together, you know, anything is possible, but I don't think any one of us expected this kind of a game, and especially this kind of a finish.
Yeah, the realignment of the teams is paying off here in year one, a much more competitive game. Talent balanced. And I'm telling you, Black Squad, 13's my man.
Getting him in open space, you said.
I would put him back to return the kick, and then I'd try to get him the ball. We're going to have Valverde back, Spencer back. Those two have connected on a huge play that fourth down that led to the Black team going on top. So here we go. They may have a couple of snaps and the kick return. Short kick. Valverde, the quarterback, will take it. He fakes the reverse, and he's got a seam. Valverde to the 30, and that'll do it. They'll have first down with 11 seconds to go. Chris Kotfuss, our fantastic producer, says hook and ladder. I don't know if you put that in with 1 week's practice time, but I think your best chance is really to bust a really talented fast back behind those 300 pounders in space. Adams is in there with Weaver in the backfield. And Adams, 13, is an absolute jet.
Coach, I know this is a, I know what, there's not a lot of plays in the playbook for 11 seconds left and 35 yards, but you're gonna just go vertical here?
We are going to chunk this football, I can promise you that. As well as she does it. Not fun.
I have one play left. They took their final timeout. 5 seconds to go. And there, like Mike Hernandez said, there's not a play in the playbook for this one. You've got to give him time. That's the most important thing.
Go. Oh, hey, turn me up. You know it's go team.
And by the way, congratulations to the local guys that played in the All-American game on the national stage today. DeMarvin Leal, 5-star blue chipper. Jordan Whittington from Cuero, who set all kinds of records in their state championship game. He's going to be a Longhorn. Leal's going to be an Aggie. Both top 100 players in the country. As Tobias Weaver is going to have 5 wides. And see what he does. He's running for his life. It's a run all the way.
Ball game.
Ball came out. Ball's recovered. Clocks hit 0. And the gold team wins the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB.
Let's go.
Got a much more coming here from the Alamodome. We'll hand out the trophies, but as we go to break, it's our Whataburger. All right, check that. It's our Children's Hospital play of the game. The UIW play of the game. And at what play it is, it's the last play. Rasko from Warren on the receiving end of the touchdown pass from Reed Anderson. And the gold team, after giving up a big lead, comes back to win it in the final minute. Finger roll from Aaron Rasko. We'll hand out the hardware when we come back.
Welcome to the San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game presented by HEB Postgame Show.
Ah, what a fun time in the Alamodome this afternoon, huh? Gold team, the winner, 33-29 over the black. Let's go down to Mike Hernandez to hand out the hardware. Mike?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for coming out today. My name is Mike Hernandez from News 4 at Fox 29, and it was a pleasure to be able to televise such a great game. How about a hand for both of these teams for the effort that they displayed today? Anytime you get this quality of athletes on the field, anything is possible, and today just about anything happened. So congratulations to the gold team. Congratulations to Team Black as well. Let's give them a big round of applause. What an effort. What a comeback. This is the 41st annual All-Star Game. We want to thank San Antonio Sports for being able to put this together. Of course, the Alamo Dome, all our coaches and their staffs for, again, taking the time to spend with the athletes this week, and to the athletes themselves. Because a lot of you guys, I know you haven't played in a while, and yet you stayed in shape, you guys enjoyed the game. Did you have a good time? Did you have a good time, guys? That's all that counts. There are no losers in a game like this. There is just fun. I'm gonna be talking to Coach here in just a second, but first, I wanna go ahead and pass out the hardware, our Whataburger Impact Trophy, most valuable player, goes to a gentleman who saved the best for last, scored two touchdowns in 45 seconds. Number 29, Eric Rasko. Where are you, Eric? Oh. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So, were you like taking a nap earlier in the game and you just decided you were going to just kind of save it all for the last year?
No, I was just being patient, waiting on my moment, and then took advantage of the time I had.
No, you did a wonderful job. I got to tell you, last 41 seconds to do what you did was tremendous. And again, it just goes to show what great athletes can do in great moments. I'd like to present to you with the Impact Player of the Game from Whataburger. Big hand for Eric Rasko. Absolutely.
I just want to give all the honor and glory to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Couldn't do any of this without him.
Thank you, Eric. Where's Coach? Where's Coach Norman? All right. Coach, fantastic job. Fantastic game. What can you say?
That was fun. It was a great game. These guys have been great all week. And, hats off to the, Black. That made, it was a great game on both sides. And I'm just proud of these guys, kept on fighting when we got down. And it was a great job.
You spent the week with them. What were your thoughts about your players?
Well, we played good football here in San Antonio. And this, these guys prove it. I know San Antonio is overlooked a lot of times, but we have great football players. We play great football, and these guys are great guys. They're better people than football players, and they're pretty dang good football players.
Yes, they are, and I agree with you totally. And thank you, too, Coach. And thank you, your staff. Hold on a second. Let me get you something that you might want to hold on to. I'd like to present to you the George Pasterchick Championship Trophy for the 41st annual San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game to Team Gold.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, guys. Here we go.
Back to you, Don.
Thanks, Mike. Congratulations to Team Gold and to Team Black for a job well done as we take a look at our Children's Hospital of San Antonio second half highlights. What a fun second half it was. We had a scoop and a score for the Gold. man from Madison. We had field goals. The kicking squad proved that they're all-stars. And late in the game, Carson Valverde of Kerrville Tivy just came through. That a fourth down completion to Elias Spencer. Then he showed off his wheels, get down to the 6-yard line to give the black squad a chance. And then that man from Marshall did the rest, put him ahead. Great game-saving interception, it looked like there. And then they made it a 7-point lead with Hastings, but the goal team wasn't to be denied. Rasko scored his first touchdown with under a minute to go. They get the extra onside kick. Rasko runs the straight route, straight down the fly route down the sideline. Finger roll at the end, and the gold team wins it. 41st annual San Antonio All-Star Game presented by HEB. Fun time here at the Alamodome today with the Army All-American Bowl and the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game. It's been our privilege to televise it here on the CW35. Our executive producer is Dean Radla from St. Clair, San Antonio. And for Mike Hernandez, Derek Macon here in the booth. Also, our statistician extraordinaire, Mark Kusenberger, back in the booth as always. Brian Watts, guys from Jeff Watts Productions, always doing a fantastic job. And Chris Kotlis, this is the cherry on top of his sundae, doing a great job on TNL all year long. Nobody puts in more hard work than Chris Kotlis, his broadcast, and we thank him for all he does for high school football here in San Antonio. We'll see you next year for Hallmark University Thursday Night Lights. We'll call it a wrap for this season of TNL and the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game presented by HEB. Good night. God bless. We'll see you next time, everybody.